Brought to you by Global Ethics Solutions.
When alcohol and substance abuse issues become performance issues at work, supervisors will need to provide both interventions and referrals. Always start by documenting the issues to help prepare and set the stage for a referral to assistance. Supervisors should approach each issue with constructive confrontation by first stating the problem with the employee, paired with attempts to allow the employee to acknowledge what they see in the problem. Supervisors should allow a set time for performance improvements to happen and specific outcomes of what will happen if problems continue. In a constructive but non-confrontational way, supervisors should address issues immediately with an employee. Following this interaction, employees will need ongoing feedback, encouragement to follow through with care, accurate performance feedback, respect for privacy, and open lines of communication. Keep in mind, respecting an employee's confidentiality is also a key element of the process. Problems are to be kept internal and conversations kept private. All information will be maintained in an employee file, and information about mental health or addiction is not a matter of public record. It is the employee's decision of whom they will or will not share information with. Navigating this can be a complex process. When a supervisor has reasonable belief an employee is currently using substances or recently used substances that are impacting their job performance, drug testing can be requested. Knowing key supervisor do's and don'ts to follow when faced with this situation can help make this process less daunting. Some key supervisor do's include identifying the specific observable behaviors, documenting observations and steps, including another supervisor as a witness. Supervisors should also follow the same steps each time an issue arises to minimize risk. These include first meeting with an employee, including human resources from the beginning, and reviewing observations while focusing on job performance standards. Also, reminding the employee of their confidentiality protections while also providing them with information on employee assistance programs creates a problem-solution-focused environment. Supervisors should avoid the following when addressing substance use issues with employees: trying to diagnose the problem, discussion of actual drugs used, being misled by sympathy for the employee, or covering up and protecting an employee. These issues are neither easy nor fun to address. However, the supervisor can play a major role in getting an employee to accept help and recognize a problem. At the end of the day, it is an employee's choice to accept help. However, a supervisor can provide resources and referrals through employee assistance programs to offsite counselors, groups, and meetings to help. Remember, supervisor responsibilities include confidentiality and creating a supportive environment for an employee to access help.
This is a Global Ethics Solutions presentation. Be sure to follow us online, like and share this presentation, and subscribe to our channel today.